that's on, that's on, and this is on, and that's on, and this is on.
And you're on. Going on.
The blind bids is an interesting one.
Is.
So it does say here that the liberals want to have a homeowner bill of rights that bans blind bids. So when we talk about blind bids, it basically it's saying that we can't disclose what the other bids are in any given transaction on any given offer night or any time at all.
It goes against what we're allowed to do right now.
It's completely against what we're allowed to do. So basically, if I have five different offers, I can't tell all the people that are submitting those offers what the other offers are. Mm-hmm. So you have no idea. And that's why it's a blind bid.
Yes.
Right? But my seller knows what they all are.
Yes.
And I know what they all are. So I guess what they're trying to do is get rid of the manipulation by probably a small portion of people that exploit that and use it to their advantage. But that's not to say they're going to exploit other things and use it to advantage. But if it's not a blind bid, are we going to go up a dollar?
It's going to be up to minimum, right? Well, and this is the thing. So, gosh, I have such like strong feelings about this on both sides.
Interesting.
Because blind bidding for my sellers equals more money in their pocket, I think, based on what I see happen on my offer nights. I'm sure you're the same.
Yeah.
You know, that house in Whitby last week, 113 showings, 37 offers. Were all 37 offers fantastic? Not at all. There was a handful.
That's right. There's a handful at the top.
Up at the top. But was that handful going to bid as heavily as they bid if the other 32 offers weren't there? Of course not. They're not going to bid as heavily.
Right.
So my sellers did well. Because we created the competition we needed to create. And I know that sounds super manipulative, but on the selling side, that's our job as
that
the,
is the job.
Agent is to do the best we can do.
That's right. And here's another hot take on that. Notice I'm calling my own comment a hot take.
I'll call it. What's your hot take?
My hot take on it is that you're not giving a blind bid. You can see it. You
true.
Can see what your bid is. You know what you're paying.
That's true.
And you can do the math and figure out what the square footage is, what the finishes
that's
are
true.
Worth, what
yes.
the lot is worth, what the neighborhood average is. You're not putting in a blind bid.
That's true. I guess
you just
yes.
are going to be a sore loser if your bid doesn't win.
Right.
But right?
that's for people that are making bids based on like actual comparable sales and like doing their homework and bidding appropriately with, you know, some really good, honest advice. From a realtor.
That's exactly
probably.
What I'm saying. I'm not saying
yes.
they're sore. Like I'm the sore loser too. I got to go back and say, sorry guys, we didn't get this. We're a team. Mm-hmm. We're going to lose sorely together.
We are.
You know?
It's a roller coaster I ride every day.
It is what it is. But yeah. the funny thing is that when I go back and I tell them and I'm like, yeah, we lost out, but I'm glad we didn't overspend on this
exactly.
because one, you could have been house broke. Two, we couldn't, maybe we didn't get the appraisal. Like there's so many issues. Like just mm-hmm. trust what I'm saying because I've done the math.
Yes.
I know what it's worth, even in this speculative market. If you want to let somebody go and pay $200,000 over, go ahead. Mm-hmm. Move along.
Yeah.
The opportunity will come. It's going to take some patience. So it's not actually
come.
A blind bid.
It does come eventually because you make a good, reasonable offer based on what it should sell for. Maybe you add a percent or two because you do want to win, but not 10%, right?
Exactly.
Or as we just saw last night on another property that sold $500,000 over asking, you know. More than I think anybody thought it would sell for. So,
for sure.
You know, it's, so I'm proud to say I never feel like my buyers are those buyers. We do land properties, but we land them fairly.
Exactly. I feel the same way.
And it takes time and patience.
That's right.
So for my buyers, you're right. It doesn't really matter either way, I guess. Although sometimes, like I had one, a condo not too long ago where we were only $4,000 off the top bidder and they never came back to me and asked for more money. My buyer was mad, and so was I. We would have paid a little bit more.
Well, see, that's if we could iron out how to make sure that everybody has equal opportunity.
Yeah.
That's the real thing they should be focused
equal
on.
Equal opportunity to increase your bid, yeah.
Exactly. It should be like, okay, yeah. we're going to do three different rounds, and, you know, I'm going to let you know. What I like to do is I like to let, you know, a lot of the bidders know I'm really transparent. And yet in that 20 offer situation yesterday, mm-hmm. I called up every single agent and I was like, you're eighth, you're fourth, you're third. You now can gauge how much money you're going to have to spend to get into the top three.
Right.
And then when you get into the top three, it's a different situation altogether because the seller's going to be more involved. Mm-hmm. the conditions are going to be more involved. Yeah. But at least, and every single realtor I talked to was so grateful and thankful that I called them at like 5 in the afternoon and not 10 at night.
Oh, tell me.
Because they just sat, they were like, I said, I don't like when I have to sit around all night and wait for an answer when I put in a bid of my people's highest and best. Mm-hmm. And I want to get back to you now.
Yeah.
And it went over so damn well.
That's so good. That'll save you on the other side when you're offering on their property.
Exactly. They'll remember that.
Courtesy is there. Honestly, courtesy. I wrap mine up quick. I'm like, sorry. Nope, this one.
Exactly.
Narrow the group and get it done.
Yes.
No one wants to be waiting around. I was waiting around on that 500,000 over one last night for a long time just to find out we were nowhere close. So.
Damn it, that makes me angry. Like, why are you letting people just sit around? Like, oh, let me focus on just the highest numbers and the competitors and everybody else is just a piece of garbage. Like, oh, no, man, this is people's real money and lives. And they're sitting there like.
They deserve their respect, right?
Yeah.
I mean,
at the end of the day,
here's the one thing we have to be careful of what we're saying, though. We are here to follow our seller's direction.
Always.
We do this the way our seller wants to do
exactly
it.
Exactly how the seller
wants.
We
can't actually control how we present and do offer. We really have to take our seller's direction on that.
That's right. Now, I have one more that I really want to talk about. Maybe we'll dive more into what the liberals want to do on our next podcast.
Let's do that. But I think that's a whole, it's a whole podcast.
It could be a whole podcast, but maybe we can touch on it in this podcast.
We'll touch on it.
Right? Because there's one.
We should dig more as to what their actual plan is.
We should dig more. We should get those bullet points and we should be like, listen, curl up with a nice little cup of coffee or a hot chocolate and get ready to be bored to shit for the next 3 hours because we're going to tell you what the government's up to.
Surprise. At some point, though, somebody must have said how. I know that's what they're going to do, but how? I want to know how.